Hi, I'm Josh Christensen, and this is my brother Derek, and we're from Pleasant Grove, Utah, and we're members of the DWR's Dedicated Hunter Program, and we've been members now for about 9 years.
That's right. We are avid outdoorsmen and hunters. We love hunting big game and small game in the great state of Utah, and we love fishing across the state. Right now, this time of year, it's early springtime, and we're in between hunting seasons, and we love to go shed hunting this time of year.
But before we actually get out and do some shed hunting, there's three things you need to remember, and you can remember them easily by remembering the three P's. First is permit, second is permission, and third is passion. The first P is permit, and what you'll need to do is go to the DWR's website, which is wildlife.utah.gov/shedantler, and there's a free online course that teaches you the ethics of shed hunting. And at the end of that course, you'll take a brief quiz. So once you're done with your quiz, it'll pop up a little permit like this, which you can print out. You'll need to sign and take with you out in the field. The second P is permission. And just like with any hunting, if you're gonna be on private land, you wanna make sure that you obtain written permission from the landowner stating that it's okay that you're on the property, and you'll wanna keep that with you while doing shed hunting. And with any public land shed hunting, you need to keep in mind that there are some wildlife management areas that are closed for shed hunting during certain times of the year. So just verify that the area that you're gonna be at is open. The third P is passion. And basically, we wanna make sure that we're not harming the environment, that we're trading legally and lightly. And again, if we're on private land, that we have written permission, and if we're using any OHVs in our shed hunting, to make sure that we stay on the trails. Not to go off blazing, making new trails, and because it's gonna hurt the environment, the wildlife habitat, and the winters are already rough and tough as it is for the animals.
All right, with that said, let's go out there and find some sheds.
Hi, sir, how are you doing?
Hi, guys, how you doing? What can I do for you?
Well, we just had a quick question for you. We were wondering if you wouldn't mind if we did some shed hunting on your property up here in the hills above.
Yeah, that'd probably be okay. Just kind of stay away from the animals so we don't want to spook them and everything, and watch the fences so you don't knock those down. And if you stay on the trails here and have a good time, you bet, you go right ahead.
Okay, would you mind deciding that for us?
Sure.
Sounds okay. Great. All right, well, thank you very much.
Have a good day.
Thank you so much.
You bet.
Sit on the ground.
Oh, baby.
Wow.
Nice.
That's the first one of the year finding that set.
All right, so it's pretty fun when you find a set like this. Sometimes they're really close together, sometimes they're really far apart. You just gotta get lucky sometimes, but it's pretty fun.
Very true. But if you ever find any antlers that are connected to the skull, don't disturb them, don't touch them. Report it to the DWR and have them come check it out first. As you can see, we had a great, successful shed hunting trip. Found some nice antlers. We had a lot of fun, a lot of good exercise, and we hope to get out again.
Yeah, we do, and before you go out, just remember the three P's that we talked about earlier. Permit, permission, and passion. Have a lot of fun, and good luck to you.
Have fun.